Hello, this is Michael McCarthy. In this video, we're going to take a look at using Ornatrix with Metal Ray. A few users have asked how to set this up, so I wanted to do a quick video that kind of shows how easy it is. I'm going to select this plane here and go and add our hair to selection using Ornatrix Quick Hair. So build a few modifiers and add our hair in. You can see it there. Next, I'm going to go to Create, Geometry, Ephere Ornatrix, and choose MR Hair. I'll click and put that in the viewport. Now under the Modify panel, under Source Hair, we'll pick our hair. And for the most part, that's all we need to do to be able to render in Metal Ray. Just click on Render with the Metal Ray renderer chosen. And we'll see our hair showing up in the render. Next, I'll just do a couple of different things. Let me brush this hair slightly, just so that it's not so uniform all the way around. We do want to just keep it on a plane because I want to talk a little bit about how to texture using Metal Ray and how we might get some different maps working in there. Under Hair from Guides, I'm just going to set the render to be a bit lower, maybe just 2000. And we'll add our Ornatrix render settings so that we can taper off the hair as we like. Now I'll click on Render again. In this scene, we don't have any significant or any lighting at all, and I'm not going to worry about that right now because just with the basic default lighting, I want to be able to see my textures. So I go into the Material Editor. Some people have asked how to set up root-to-tip textures and how also to do maybe a little bit of variation on the hair. So the first thing I want to look at is how our default texturing works. This one has been applied to the plane, and because of that, it gets applied to the hair automatically. If I add in a diffuse map, I'm just going to add a checker map quickly. I'll give it a few tiles. We'll turn on Show Map and Viewport, and you can see on the emitting mesh, here is our checker pattern. And what's going to happen is the hair below it is going to inherit this, and as far as its UVs are concerned, it's going to get the color that is on the mesh below. And this is great for furry or creatures or even hair that's textured on characters. So you can see that color come through in the checker pattern, which is what we want. Now if I want to do something with root to tip, what I'll do is just go and choose something like a gradient ramp. And inside here, the root to tip information is exported through the MR primitive using the W coordinate. So we're going to choose VW. And let's just choose a color that is going to be really easy to see. So we'll say red at the bottom and blue at the top. You can certainly choose a color that's going to be much more realistic and interesting. I'm going to apply this there. We'll just do a quick render. So in this case, we actually have the blue over on this side and the red on this side. Let's go back into our gradient, and we're going to use WU. And then you'll see we get the root to tip that we're looking for with red at the bottom and blue at the tip. Now if we want to combine these two, we could do something with maybe the composite map. Let's just go and grab a composite map. Keep this whole map as a submap. So this will be our root to tip. Let me add in a new map. And in here, I'll choose something like a noise map. For noise, I'm going to set it to the explicit map channel. And I'm going to remove the W coordinate for tiling because we wouldn't want it to tile up the hair. We just wanted to use it as we did with the checker. Let me set my noise to something fairly small, like a 0.1. And let's clamp the value slightly so that we can really see where the whites and the darks meet, making it a little bit more contrasting. Now, if we render this out, what we should get is some hairs that are black and some hairs that are white, depending on what is below. So that looks pretty good. And we can blend this in with our root to tip, which is using a different coordinates. So let me just go in here and we'll say multiply. So obviously anything that is black will be a little bit darker, and anything that's white will stay white. So this is actually going to make some of the hairs darker in those areas and some of the hairs lighter in others. So here you can see how we can get a little bit of variation. This is a bit extreme. We could go in and, of course, instead of multiplying with a very, very dark color, we can bring that up like so, so that we don't get, you know, completely black hairs. And we can use all sorts of different blend modes here. So this gives us some interesting variation. Of course, you could use an additive mode. So with addition, you know, the whites are going to make it brighter. And of course, there's some other kind of fun ones that we could use, like difference. So you can kind of pick which sort of blend mode, and of course use opacity in order to get some different results like that. So that's a few different ways to go ahead and texture your hair. Now, you can use any shaders that you wish. As far as Metal Ray shaders, Max doesn't ship with a default hair shader, but you can go out and download the Puppet stuff, which seems to be fairly popular. And of course, you can use just the Arch and Design and texture your hair how you like. So we can use our Arch and Design material. I'll grab this map and just copy it. We'll go down into the map section. I'll just paste this in diffuse color. We'll get that there. We can apply it to our hair. We'll just try maybe a different blend mode too. Value seems to be an interesting one as well. So there's a quick example of how you can render Metal Ray hair using Ornatrix, how you can set up the, you know, using render settings, the tip being a little bit more tapered and adjust the curvature, as well as how you can texture using both root to tip, as well as the UVs from the source generating mesh. Hopefully that helps you out. Thank you very much.